Hi, this is Jillian, and today I'm going to show you how to use Fieldwire for scheduling your projects. Project schedules have become more fast-paced than ever before, and it's critical to meet every deadline all within budget. With Fieldwire, you can easily stay on top of your schedule with the calendar and Gantt view, as well as assign and distribute work through tasks. First, we will start out on the web version of Fieldwire, and I'll show you how to create tasks for the schedule activities on your project through the task importer, and then how to check the overall progress of your project through the calendar and Gantt view on web. I'll finish on the mobile version to show you how the whole project team is able to coordinate and stay on track. Currently, I'm on the Tasks tab on my project. We are about to start MEP Ruffins and Building 1 next week, and I want to make sure that each trade is able to coordinate their work effectively, and we're able to stay on schedule. In order to do so, I'm going to create tasks for each Ruffin activity. I can create individual tasks or quickly create multiple tasks with the task importer. Click Import Tasks in the upper left, then all I need to do is copy and paste in the line items for my 3-week look ahead. I've also included the priority, category, assignee, and start and end dates of each activity. Once I click Import Tasks, each individual task is created and my subtrades are instantly notified. Now, everyone on the project is able to coordinate their work and update their tasks with important information or communicate any delays through messages and photos. You no longer have to have long weekly meetings to figure out when and how everyone is going to accomplish their work because everything is easily communicated through Fieldwire tasks. Here I am back on the Tasks tab. Let's switch over to the calendar view. I can filter which tasks I want to look at so I can get a more focused idea on the progress of certain areas of work, trades, or individuals. There's a variety of filters based on the task attributes as well as time filters. I'll select electrical, mechanical, and plumbing from the categories dropdown so we can take a look at the Ruffin task that I just created. I'm currently viewing the entire month. I can also look at just this week or even down to a certain day. I did just get an update from my mechanical sub that they don't have the manpower to complete their Ruffin for level 1 by next Tuesday. So I'll quickly extend the end date by hovering over the end of the task and dragging to the right. Then I'll select the second level Ruffin task and move it out to start on a later date. Please keep in mind that tasks are not dependent on each other. I also just got an update from my electrical sub that they are on schedule and can start level 3 Ruffin at the end of the month. So I'm going to add a task to the schedule by clicking on the calendar. Now the task is assigned to them and we can start tracking the work. As my subs finish their Ruffins and complete the tasks, the task will turn green and I can then go do a quick quality control walkthrough. I can verify all the completed tasks by selecting them, then clicking on the Actions dropdown and marking them as verified. This way, I can ensure that all the trades Ruffins are not only complete, but completed correctly and ready for inspection. We also have the Batch Edit feature, where you can mark multiple tasks as verified or edit a variety of other task attributes. I can then generate a CSV report later on, and it will show me the dates the tasks were completed and verified. You will have clear insight to see if tasks were completed early or late. Check out our video on generating reports to learn more. Next, I'm going to show you Fieldwire's Gantt view. The Gantt view is a great way to visualize the start and end dates on your project and monitor the progress of your scheduled tasks. You can filter, extend dates, and drag and drop tasks here just like you can on the calendar view. Using the from and to at the top of the screen, I can set the date range to view my schedule. You also are able to sort tasks by category, status, assignee, plan, and location. By default, the tasks will be sorted by start date and end date. Sorting by location helps you visualize the scheduled work in an area to make sure you don't have trades working on top of each other. And sorting by assignee or category gives you an understanding of the workload on a specific person or team. The last thing I want to show you while on the Gantt view is how to quickly add start and end dates to tasks. Now that I've verified my Ruffins are good to go, I'll want to schedule my inspections so everything passes and there is no holdup in the schedule. I'll select the task from the right-hand side and drag and drop directly onto the Gantt chart. The task will be automatically updated with the start and end dates. You can also do this on the calendar view. Now let's switch over to Fieldwire's mobile app. Fieldwire is available on iOS and Android and works both online and offline, making it easy to use by the entire project team. Each field crew member can pull up their scheduled tasks on their tablet or smartphone while out on site and see what work needs to get done. Here we are on my electrical subs tablet. The task view will default to show what is overdue, due today, and the priorities of the task. He can sort by start or end date and get a simple, easy-to-read list of his tasks. As work is completed, he can edit the task and change the priority to complete. If there are any issues or delays that might affect completing the task on time, he can add updates through messages and include photos to visually document the issue. I will receive an instant notification that the task has been updated and can see all the documentation of the comments, photos from the field, and when my electrical sub updated it in real time. I can then move the end date and make any adjustments to the project schedule. Things will no longer slip through the cracks, and your project schedule will run smoother than ever before. That was an overview of how to use FieldWire for scheduling. Thanks for watching!